Hey everybody, I want to once again take the time to show you how quick testing at the DLC with just a basic multimeter can lead to the right diagnosis of a vehicle. In this case, the student was having trouble with communication, and I think not understanding how powers and grounds play such an important role for the CAN bus, they were misled and kind of went down the wrong path here. But when we get into it, basically we see that we have high voltage on the CAN line. I was thrown off on this one because the fuel pump kept on running all the time, so I just kind of went towards that direction thinking maybe a fuel pump module was shorted or something internally, which I have seen before raise the CAN voltage. So I hope you guys enjoy this. By the way, guys, if you're an automotive technician, keep up with your training and stuff. I'm trying to learn all the time and get more of an understanding. I read books like this. I'm reading this book, Electricity Demystified, off Amazon. It's really helping me think about and learn better ways to understand electricity, and also when I try and help others and try and teach others, it's making me think in different ways I haven't before. So keep on learning. Have a great day, everybody, and enjoy this video. Key on engine off. We do not have a check engine light, so no check engine light here. I don't know if you can hear or not, but the fuel pump's running non-stop. I'll run through and do a complete DTC scan here. See what pops up. And as this thing's gonna go through and do this, I'm thinking about, well, if our body control module's talking, that's good. Let's find out what's not communicating here. Okay, so no communication, driver's door switch, ECM, fuel pump control module, liftgate module, passenger door switch, rear HVAC, TCM, vehicle communication interface module. And when we get down to the other modules here, SRI, we got EVCM. Let's see, we got all those talking, so I'm going to take a look here. Okay, so right off the bat here, guys, as always, like to test at the DLC. The breakabout box does do its job here of showing us that we do have voltage to the DLC. What I'm looking at is I got this is millivolts, so I got a 100 millivolt difference between pins 4 and 5 here, which it's a little bit off, a little bit on a higher side than I'm used to. But where this really gets interesting is if we go to pin 14, we got 6.9 volts, okay? And if we go to pin 6, we got 7.25 volts, okay? So we definitely have a bus problem here. Investigate further and bring you along. Okay, in the essence of trying to keep things simple, I disconnected the fuel pump control module because I noticed that the fuel pump was running all the time, and that's kind of odd. And we do have a resistance between pins 6 and 14 of what it should be of 123 ohms. Now I'll show you, thinking about this, how I was thinking about it. The fuel pump control module is going to separate the circuit, so whether this vehicle has the rear differential control module or not, it doesn't really matter. We know we're looking at the other half of the circuit from our DLC. Let's see. Our DLC comes in here, and going this way, we've eliminated the fuel pump control module, disconnected this. So we have an open circuit over here. So we're not reading this resistor or this one, depending on the options. We're definitely reading the ECM resistor. So let me go ahead and try and plug that back in and see if our resistance stays the same. All right, guys, so once again, it's trying to find the easiest possible things to access. Disconnected ABS module. And now our bus voltage is 2.5 volts on pin
14. Let me check what we got on pin 6. Should have 2.7 or so, 2.6 volts. So with the ABS module disconnected, we're back and looking good. So what I want to show everybody is on a schematic, all I'm doing is I'm trying to find a way to separate the system. I went to the fuel pump control module because I heard a fuel pump running all the time, disconnected that, didn't have any change in the system. And then I went over here to the ABS module and we have the proper voltage on the CAN bus. So we'll continue the hunt. So I'm looking, we got the ABS module disconnected and everything's good. The next module along the line is the TCM. If I disconnect the TCM and communication comes back to all the modules on the network minus the TCM and the PCM here, we'll know we're on the right path. Here we are with the transmission control module plugged in and the engine control module disconnected, and our voltage is up back high, 5.49 volts. That's pretty bad. I'm thinking about getting a scope out here to take a look at it. But we can still communicate with our fuel pump control module, and we do have communication with the ABS module. So we're still talking to these things. Let me take a look. So we got our transmission control module plugged back in. Let's see if it's talking. And no communication with that one. Interesting. So being that we have high voltage when I have that transmission control module plugged back in, I'm thinking we got to take a look at the grounds to the TCM. I might jump and bypass it and see if we can at least get communication to the ECM here. Alright guys, remember the 6.5 or 7 volts we had on our CAN line before? Well, I'm back probing into the TCM power, TCM ground. Listen to this. This is G110 back here. What the heck did I do? I don't even know. I just touched it. It ain't taking much here. Oh, there it is. There we go. So right now we're showing a 20 millivolt drop. Go this way. Oh. And we've got 9 millivolts. The problem's way back in here. G110 is on one of these wires way back in around, and it kind of like blinks the side of the block or the head. I can't quite see it myself to get down there, but just watching our voltage here right now, we're showing on the ground voltage dropping the ground at the TCM, showing 8 millivolts. Not a big deal, no problem. Let's give this a wiggle and see what happens. Reaching back down there the best I can. I got the meter going crazy trying to catch up. We got 6/10 of a volt. So I'm trying to wiggle it and find out what I gotta do to make this thing be good. But as I'm just barely touching with my fingers down there. That's what a bad ground will do for you. So we gotta get there back there and repair that ground, but the TCM is communicating. And let's see if our engine control module is communicating, because we had no communication with the engine control module before. And it's probably going to be, it's alive. Perfect. Let's see what this code is. Not that it matters much.
If you or your shop are interested in hands-on auto training, contact us via the website. We'd be more than happy to take an analysis of where you're at with you and your technicians and help you guys get to the next level. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.